Hi friends, this is Gani. In this video, I'm going to explain you how to use selection filters in TechClass structures. Just like how to select only columns in entire structure, or how to select only brace in entire structure, or how to select these channels in entire structure with using selection filters. Before going to explain about selection filters, for more TechClass structure related videos, please go to my channel. youtube.com/GaniSK. I will provide this link in the description below of this video. Please go through it and come here. Under videos, you can find out so many TechClass structure related videos. I hope these videos might be helpful to you. And at the top right corner, please click on subscribe button. If you subscribe, you will get notification or updates when I upload a new video. So please click on subscribe. Okay, let's start. Before going to use these selection filters, I'm going to delete entire structure, and once again I'm going to create for you. Go to steel and select the column and place it here and double click on it. Make sure that under the name it should be column, and you can change the profile and height and bottom length according to your requirement, and then place it here just like this. Then I'm going to take beam and place it here up to here. It should be beam, and close it. Now I'm going to split into different parts, so go to edit and select the split and select the beam and split at here, and select once again and split it here. Now these are the two different beams. Now we're going to select all this column and beam and hold the control button and select this grid to unselect it. Then right click on mouse, copy from here to here, select at grid intersection points. Right click on mouse, interrupt, and click on space. Now we are going to create beam in this direction. So go to steel and select the beam once again and pick the first point at here and select second point at here. Now this is the single beam. We are going to break into two beams. So go to edit once again and select the split option and select the beam and select at here. Select one more time and select at here, and select one more time, select at here. Now here you can see, now these are the four different beams. Now hold the control button and select all the beams and right click on mouse, copy from here to, click on grid intersection point here. That's it. Now we have the beams. Now we are going to place channels in between the beams here. So go to steel once again and select the beam and click the midpoint. This triangle indicates the midpoint. Now we don't require any beam here. We require channels. So double click on it to get the property here. Now click on here and select the channel. Here you can see name, under the name it should be channel. Click on modify, close it. Use the control 2 for transparent view. You can see this is the channel. You can rotate and see this exactly. This is the channel profile. So we're going to take, use the control 4 for solid view and beam, select beam once again. We're going to take here also channels. That's it. Hold the control button to exit the command. Use the escape button. Hold the control button and select all the channels and right click on mouse, copy from here to at. Click on every grid intersection point to place all the channels. Then click on space to unselect the channels. Here you can see. Now we have the channels and beams. Now we are going to place here the braces. So go to beam once again, select it, and pick the gradient intersection point to up to here. Now we are going to change this channel to this angle. So select the brace. We are going to change the profile here. Instead of WT, we are going to take angle profile. So minimize it and maximize this angle profile. For example, I'm going to take here 4 by 4 by 1 by 4 inch thickness. You can choose as you require the profile and click on modify and close it. Now select the beam once again and select from here to here and escape it, and hold the control button, select the both angles, right click on mouse, copy from here to here and escape it, hold the control button and select these two angles and these two angles also, then right click on mouse, copy from here to here. That's it. Okay, now we have angles, angle braces and beams and channels and columns in this whole structure. So now we are going to use the selection filters here. Now our requirement is, for example, we are going to select only the columns in the entire structure. So come here, these are the selection filters, select from here. Let's take here steel columns, steel underscore columns, select it. Now select, drag and select the whole structure. Here you can see you will select only the columns. Okay, click on space to unselect it. For beams, you want to select only beams in the whole structure. So come here and browse from here, select steel underscore beam. Now drag and select entire structure. Here you can see only beams will be selected. That's it. Okay, now we are going to select only the channels in the entire structure. So come here and steel underscore channel, select it and drag and select the whole structure. Here you can see only channel will be selected with the selection filter like this. Okay, for example, you want to select only the angles, angle brace in the entire structure. So come here, steel underscore brace, select it and hold, drag and select the whole structure. Here you can see only braces will be selected in the entire structure. Like that, you can select only required profile in whole structure like this. Okay, after selection completed, you need to select the standard, otherwise you won't select any objects in the structure. Okay, that's it. This is about selection filter, how to use the selection filter in the model Tekla structures. If you have any doubts, please comment below. If you like this video, please like it and share it. For more Tekla structure related videos, please go to my channel youtube.com/GaniSK. I will provide this link in the description below of this video. Please go through it and come here. Under videos, you can find out so many Tekla structure related videos. I hope these videos might be helpful to you. And at the top right corner, please click on subscribe button. If you subscribe, you will get notification or updates when I upload a new video. So please click on subscribe. Thank you.